former sheriff the right thing to do? It's not about the law. It's about the morality at play and the fact that the sheriff violated a court order from two different federal judges. So Congressman Steve King from Iowa just told us that profiling, which is what he says Joe Arpaio was doing, is necessary for law enforcement. He draws a distinction between profiling and racial profiling. That gets a little confusing. Let's discuss. CNN political commentator Jen Psaki, former White House communications director and former State Department spokesperson, and former Republican Pennsylvania Senator Rick Santorum, CNN senior political commentator. What did you hear in that discussion, Rick? What are the merits of the decision from your perspective?
Well, what I heard with respect to what Steve King was saying is that, you know, Joe Arpaio did violate the law. Obviously, you wouldn't be pardoned if you weren't convicted of something. I mean, that's what I'm finding a little confusing here, that you're saying it's the morality of it and all of these other factors, but you don't get pardoned unless you did something wrong and that you were going to be, you know, sentenced, or you in fact were sentenced and convicted. Obviously, Joe Arpaio wasn't sentenced yet, but there's no doubt that Joe Arpaio broke the law. So that otherwise we wouldn't be talking about a pardon.
Right. No.
So
no.
I'm
no.
Not too sure.
You're misunderstanding what I'm saying. I'm saying that the president's ability legally to pardon is not a real issue. He has almost complete authority to pardon anybody he wants, other than in matters of impeachment. I'm saying this
is
about...
You just find this particular offense very heinous.
I'm saying that's the issue.
It's an extraordinarily heinous offense.
It doesn't have to be heinous to be morally wrong, I don't think. I mean, your Catholicism is stronger than mine, but I don't think that's the only level of wrongdoing. Do you agree with the pardon?
Are you suggesting that these other people who were pardoned didn't do morally wrong things? I mean, let's go back through every one of the Obama pardons.
They got convicted of something, as you point out, but I think
there
are different levels and different issues. Do you agree with the pardon, just to get an answer?
Well, I don't agree at the timing of the pardon. I think he should have been sentenced. I think maybe he should have served some time. That would have been my my preference. But I, as far as the actual pardon, I probably would have done it myself at some point, yes.
Jen Psaki, but you guys argument keeps coming up. But you guys, you Obama people, you pardon lots of people, bad people. And so why should there be any outrage about what the new president is doing? What is your response?
Well, look, I think on the legal front, they went through a process and a consideration that went through the Department of Justice, and that didn't happen here, which I think is raising a lot of red flags for people. But I think, Chris, to your morality morality point, the issue here is this is ripping open. He's almost a symbol of a lot of the racial divisions that have been a part of our country and our fabric for decades, about the treatment and the disparity of treatment between people of different racial backgrounds by law enforcement officials. And this is a painful reminder to a lot of people of that. So that's why this is really about, why did President Trump make this decision to make this his first pardon? Somebody who is going to continue to divide and not unite the country at a point when we really needed unity and not division.
Rick?
Well, I would say that that's probably going to be the case in any high-profile pardon. I mean, you go back to Private Manning and the decision by President Obama to give that pardon. That certainly ripped open a lot of wounds, that a lot of people were harmed by the information that was leaked. Mm-hmm. And you know, I would say it was a very immoral
pardon.
But
President Obama
opinion.
Didn't say what Chelsea Manning did was okay. In fact, she's a hero. He didn't say that,
and
right?
And he commuted her. He commuted her,
right,
which
commuted the sentence. She was actually serving time, and the president's reckoning was she served enough, looking at other cases in similar nature and context. This is enough time, so I'm commuting the sentence. Certainly controversial. But what President Trump is saying here isn't he's done enough time. It's he's done nothing wrong. Violating federal orders, two different judges finding contempt, there's nothing wrong with that. It makes him a hero. Do you have any problem with that message, Rick?
You know, I don't like that message, to be honest with you. I mean, I think it's one thing to pardon someone who you think was wronged by the system, or you believe was not treated fairly by the system. And I think there's certainly a lot of evidence out there that he wasn't treated fairly by the system. But I think it's one thing to do that. It's another thing to revel in suggesting that that he was a hero. I think in some respects, if you look at his history, certainly he served this country in a lot of different respects and served it admirably. And if he's referring to, you know, his time in the service and other things that he did, certainly he has a strong and long record of service to our country. And maybe that's what he's referring to.
He has a long record, that's for sure. We'll let the historians sort it out. Rick Santorum, thank you very much. Jen Psaki, as always. Up next, we're going to